Mostly quiet, Mazinga on Bugala Island accommodates three landing sites of Kachungwa, Buyinja and Businde.
In far distant islands of Mazinga in Kalangala district is where we've discovered this kind of rock shaped in a bridge format. And then when you look at it, you wonder how God created it. Let me take you around and you get to experience what I'm talking about.
Shaped in a bridge format, this is a rock which used to attract some local tourists, as Robert Muganga narrates.
Very many people used to come here and spend nights around this place, and business people would benefit.
It's alleged that in the history of this rock, which has different caves beneath it, used to be a worshipping area where people used to spend most of their time. Aloysius Kakonge, who has spent 30 years at Kachungwa landing site, narrates on the history of this rock alongside its caves. They used this place as a worshipping center traditionally and later liked it so much to a tourist attraction before his death. He always kept it safe with the trees around it. He thinks that instead of letting people use it anyhow, the government should take over and develop it for more income through tourism. The government should have sensitized the public on this place because the young generation needs more history of such places. Before the late Saint Egude used to allow us to visit these caves beneath, pick some money from the baskets and later bring it back after finalizing your problems, which is not the case to date. The Mazinga sub-county chairperson, Sandy Gerard Keita, asks the islanders to guard it jealously. It would be wise for these places to be handed over to government, develop it for revenue collection due to its unique features that can draw more attention to tourism. As many other tourism sites on these islands lie idle, some stakeholders, including some Kwesiga, have suggested possible ways that can help to unveil them to the public.
We urge the government to help those tourism sites, the site owners, so that they can develop their sites. They can just have their latrines and whatever, so that the people can just go beyond Bugala Island.
The underdevelopment of these sites is also another barrier.
Again, we urge the government at least to help the site owners that they can develop their sites.
Julio Cesar Nyenibe, one of the tourists visiting Kalangala for the third time, says that though they went to visit other islands, they are not well marketed as Bugala is, with its beaches and easy accessibility.
Reality, where you have an island next to a border, you want to also have that feeling of being in Uganda as if you're in Kenya. You know, the borderline thing should be one of the things that should entice us. But I think if the advertising is also intensive, it can also help us to think out more than Kalangala alone, and also tend to want to visit the other islands, which are also available to people.
While on these islands, sunrise and sunset can turn your sorrows into happiness as you enjoy the sail, though many fear wooden boats.
Such places and many more are still lying idle in Sese Islands, including the falls that are found on Bukasa Island. I am Samuel Onkuba, reporting for the news in Kalangala District.